Is the Theranos experience and all the press, is that going to, what do you think is going to be the ripple effect for other biotech investments, particularly when you see a lot of kind of pure tech investors who seem to have been getting into biotech lately?
Well, it's probably not that different than when technology investors wanted to become green tech investors. I think there are a lot of, and then that didn't work out so well.
Yeah.
That's the moral of that story. But I think the people that invested that money into Theranos might be more careful next time when the next one comes along. I don't think there's a massive...
Do you think they're being more careful? Because this story is now 7 months old, and we're still seeing a bunch of tech investors investing in biotech.
You know, when we invest in biotech, it's usually alongside other investors, Third Rock, Polaris, SV Life Sciences, that we respect and have worked with. We have a deep technical team of MDs and bioengineers, et cetera, so we do our own diligence. We try to build a board that has experience in the life sciences, just as you would in any field. So I don't know what the overall ripple effect is, other than it's I think the rings probably hurt most and reach furthest into the patients, unfortunately, who trusted their health to this blood test and then steered them to wrong answers in a lot of cases.
Yeah.
And I think that kind of company in healthcare deserves and requires a level of scrutiny and oversight that maybe tech companies in general. I mean, if you just look at the amount of scrutiny that Uber gets when they're trying to move people from one place to another, and compare that to the scrutiny that Theranos got when they rolled out blood testing centers to Walgreens all over the country, that something seems not quite in balance there.
Do you think Walgreens completely dropped the ball? Do you think Walgreens simply wasn't paying attention?
I have no idea. I think that all we did was we went and had the blood test done, and it seemed obvious to us that something wasn't right with it.
And just to add to that, because I think it's a broader theme, not just outside of biotech, but I think what's happened in this kind of seller's market is people are not doing their diligence. And you see that, and it's just kind of taking what a management team says at face value and not being able to follow up with it. And part of it is the competitive dynamic of so many sources of supply chasing opportunity has created companies not having to share quite as much as they would outside of kind of the bubble we've been in. But I mean, I see it in, as I'm sure Bill does as well, on the consumer internet side, you know, companies manufacturing customer lifetime value relative to customer acquisition cost data. And companies have gotten so good at manipulating that data and putting figures in front of you in a presentation that look great, but you realize it's totally convoluted the way that they got to those ratios. And unless you have the ability and the strict need to follow up and dig into it, you can be misled. And I think that it's happened outside of just kind of biotech, but kind of in general in this bubble environment.
I think what happens is this kind of thing happens when people invest in the idea and not the execution. I think people mentally, the media, et cetera, invested in the idea that wouldn't it be great if we could test blood in this way and not the execution. The idea is the easy part. And there were no peer-reviewed journals, there was no data, et cetera. It's the execution that we care about.